Hello Dissenters, my name is Etalyx and I am here today with a little update for the Tale of Kingship mod by Tiber Alex. This is, if you have forgotten, the sequel to Tale of Kingdoms, the ever-so-popular mod from a couple years back, and I wanted to give you guys a brief update to show you what's been changing since my first preview video. Which reminds me, if you missed that, you want to see a little bit more details about Tale of Kingship and what it has to offer, check out that first video. The link is in the description of this video. Just look below. In the most recent updates to Tale of Kingship, we now have a starter town. Beginning a fresh new world and pressing the kingdom key, which is Y, is going to bring up a menu that allows you to start your adventure. This definitely brings back some memories from Tale of Kingdoms. However, this particular menu serves to cover a loading screen. As it loads on top, you're going to get a brief little history of what's going on in this game world and some epic music to go along with it. When the mod is finished loading, you'll get a little starter town nearby to get your bearings. This is not to be confused with your kingdom, it is not part of your kingdom, it's just simply a place that you can go to rest, recuperate, and there are a few other things you can do as well. Just like in Tale of Kingdoms, there is a man you can find who will bestow bread upon you if you have none, and in addition, there's a marketplace. Here in the marketplace, you can go up to these different vendors, and they're going to have various items for purchase. They're going to require gold pieces from you, which you can get from killing mobs out in the overworld. But the prices are pretty expensive here. One Minecraft night worth of grinding is only going to get you around 500 coins or so. That's just a guess on my part. So you can see just how expensive these items are. You're going to be having to save up quite a bit of cash in order to actually buy anything from here. That notwithstanding, there are a few interesting looking NPCs. For example, a priest in the church. I don't think you can interact with him at this moment. As well as a familiar face in the guild. Yes, that's right, the guild master. With the guild master, you're going to be able to do a few different tasks. For example, I have one where I have to present him with some steak. I haven't actually gotten to test any of these quests, aka tasks, out quite yet, so I'm not sure if they contribute to your honor, but you do have to grind your honor a little bit before you can become king. Now, to do that, if you want to do the tasks, you can. If you'd rather just grind mobs, you can do that as well, and it is possible to do that in about one Minecraft night worth of killing people. And by people, I mean creepers, zombies, and spiders, not those innocent villagers inside of your starter town, of course. But when you are finished, you're going to be able to go back to the guild master with your full honor meter, and you're going to be able to receive a little bit of backstory on what is about to transpire. The Reficules from Tale of Kingdoms have made a triumphant return. Currently, they act pretty much how they did in Tale of Kingdoms. However, the primary difference is they don't randomly spawn all over the face of Minecraftia. They did that before, creating fire pits and gaping holes to the center of the void, and they don't do that any longer. What's gonna happen this time, though, is you've actually triggered a Reficule attack, and you have a little over a couple minutes, so you have a little bit of time to prepare. Not much, though, and when that timer is up, hellfire will rain from the skies above. Meteors will crash down on your innocent little starting village. The villagers will cry in fear and run away, but the fire and brimstone will consume them all. It's a very cool sight, seeing all the meteors come down, the Reficules popping out and attacking everyone, setting everything on fire, and you're going to have to fight them off. So good luck. There's so many there. They take like 5 or 6 hits from a diamond sword before they die, so perhaps a little bit too strong in my opinion, considering how many there are. I would just abandon the town altogether. That's just my personal opinion until that gets fine-tuned a little bit more and looked at a little bit more closely. So, considering how many there are, they're very strong and they're going to be fearsome foes. So, if you want your own quest, a purpose in Tale of Kingship, what you should do is abandon the village with your new scepter, set out to create your own kingdom, and then make a goal for yourself to one day come back and reclaim the village for your own. Anyways, guys, just wanted to give you a nice little update for Tale of Kingship. As more is added to the mod, I will be happy to make some more videos letting you know what's new, because I am positive that Tiber Alex is going to keep working on this mod and making it far better than Tale of Kingdoms ever was. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, let me know by leaving me a like and a comment below. I would appreciate it very much. Thank you for watching. My name is Etalyx, and I will see you next time.